Hello students, this is Professor Srinivasan here. I'm uploading a very short video explaining the concept of duration in the context of bonds. What do we mean by duration? Duration represents the time within which the bond provides the targeted cash flow to the investor. Now, we all know that the value of the bond is nothing but the present value of the cash flows that are expected to accrue from the bond. For example, let's say there is a 2-year 10% bond, that is a 2-year bond which pays a coupon of 10%, which has a face value of 1 lakh, on which the investor's expected yield is 10%. Now, if you notice it carefully, you'll realize that in this case, the coupon of the bond is 10% and the yield is also 10%. And by now you would know that when the coupon of the bond is equals to the yield, the price of the bond will obviously be equal to par, that is 1 lakh. Let's construct a table showing the cash flows. So you have the first column year, the second column cash flow, third column the present value factor at 10%, that is the discounting rate at 10%, which is the yield rate, and you have the discounted cash flow. So for the first year, he's going to get a cash flow of 10,000, that is a coupon 10%, which will be discounted using the PV factor at 10% for 1 year. And in the second year, he's going to get a cash flow of 1,10,000. Now, what is this 1,10,000? This 1,10,000 is coupon for the second year, 10,000 rupees, and the principal repayment which will happen at the end of the second year, 1,00,000 rupees. So at the end of the second year, the investor is going to get a cash flow of 1,10,000 rupees, which would be discounted using the PV factor of 10% for 2 years. And the sum total of all the discounted cash flows, as you can see, is 1,00,000 rupees, which is the price of the bond. Now, this is again, like I mentioned earlier, it is quite obvious, because since the coupon and the yield are equal, the price of the bond must be equal to the par value or the face value, which is 1,00,000. Now, what are the conclusions that we can draw from this? The first conclusion is that an investor who requires a 10% yield from this bond will be willing to pay a price of rupees 1,00,000. Or in other words, an investor who buys the bond for a price of 1,00,000 will earn a yield of 10% over the 2-year period. Now, you can look at it whichever way you want. Now, if you look at the table, you'll see that the sum total of the cash flow is 1,20,000. Now, this is what we call as the targeted cash flow. That is, an investor, when he buys the bond paying a price of 1,00,000 rupees, he expects to get a cash flow of 1,20,000 rupees over a period of 2 years. Now, herein comes the concept of duration. Duration tells us that the investor, to achieve his targeted cash flow, need not actually hold the bond for 2 years. In fact, he can hold it for less than 2 years and still achieve his targeted cash flow of 1,20,000. Now, how is this possible? If you look at the table, the first year coupon, 10,000 rupees, which is received at the end of the first year, will obviously not be kept idle. It is going to be reinvested, and this reinvestment will obviously earn additional income, and this additional income will help the investor attain his targeted cash flow of 1,20,000 rupees much before 2 years. Let's simplify this a little bit. Rupees 1,00,000, which is invested today at 10%, will get the investor rupees 1,10,000 at the end of the first year. Then in the second year, rupees 1,10,000 would be invested at 10%, which will amount to 1,21,000 at the end of the second year. But the problem is, the investor is aiming for a targeted cash flow of only 1,20,000. He doesn't need 1,21,000, which he would receive at the end of the second year. He needs only 1,20,000. In the second year, we are earning an interest of 11,000, that is 10% on 1,10,000. But in reality, we don't need this 11,000. We need only an additional 10,000 in year 2. Because remember, we have already earned 10,000 rupees in the first year. If we earn another 10,000 rupees in the second year, that will make it 20,000, and the principal amount of the bond 1,00,000, so 1,20,000. But if he holds it till the end of the second year, he is going to earn 1,21,000. So that implies that the investor need not hold the bond for the entire second year, because he doesn't require the 11,000, he requires only 10,000. So now we can do a simple calculation. That is, in the second year, if 11,000 rupees is earned by holding the bond for 12 months, then within how much period will the investor earn 10,000 rupees? So that is 10,000 into 12 by 11,000, which gives us 10.90 months or 0.908 years. What this implies is that the investor needs to hold the bond for the entire first year, so that's 1 year, and for the second year, he needs to hold it only for 10.90 months or 0.908 years. So that means that he's got to hold the bond only for 1.908 years or 1.91 years. Hence, we conclude that the investor needs to hold the bond only for 1.91 years to achieve his targeted cash flow of 1,20,000. This calculation explains to you the concept of duration. But the problem is, if you have a bond which is of a longer duration, say 20 years, and which pays coupon half yearly, calculating the duration using this method is going to be quite troublesome. So we have a shortcut. And what is that shortcut? What we do is we continue with our example of the 2 year bond. So you have year 1 and 2, the cash flows 10,000 and 1,10,000, then the PV at 10%, the discounted cash flows. Now up to here the table is the same exactly like the way we prepared earlier, but now what we do is we find the proportion of the discounted cash flow of each year to the total discounted cash flow. That means the proportion of the first year would be 9090.91 divided by 1 lakh, which gives us 0.09 as the proportion. And for the second year, the proportion can be calculated by dividing 90909.09 by 1 lakh. So you get the second year proportion. The next step that we do is we give time weightage. Now, time weightage is nothing but multiplying the proportion with the year column. So 0.09 multiplied by 1 gives us 0.09, 0.91 multiplied by 2 gives us 1.82, and the sum total of time weighted duration gives us 1.91, which, if you remember, was the duration that we calculated using our method earlier. But another interesting thing that you need to note here is that the duration of a coupon bearing bond is always less than its life. Now, we in our example had taken a 2 year bond, and if you notice, the duration comes to 1.91 years, which is less than 2 years. Now, this would hold true for all coupon bearing bonds. Let's take another example and let's solve a sum. Let's say we are trying to find a duration of a 7 year, 12% bond, that is a bond which has got a life of 7 years and a coupon of 12%, which is trading at a yield of 10%. So, since it's a 7 year bond, we have in the year column, we have 7 years. And these are the cash flows, that is 12 rupees coupon every year, and in the last year he is going to receive the 12 rupees as coupon and the principal repayment of rupees 100. These cash flows will be discounted at 10%, which is the yield. You get the discounted cash flow, and the sum total of the discounted cash flow we know is the price of the bond, which is 109.74. Then the next step, as I explained in the earlier slide, we are going to find the proportion of the discounted cash flows. So the proportion for the first year would be 10.91 divided by 109.74. For the second year, it's going to be 9.92 divided by 109.74. And the third year is going to be 9.02 divided by 109.74, and so on. And next, we multiply the proportion with the year column, and the sum total of time weightage proportion gives us the duration. And if you notice here, the duration is 5.20 years. And what was the life of the bond? The bond has a life of 7 years. That is, it's a 7-year bond and it's got a duration of 5.2. Remember what I told you? The duration of a coupon bearing bond will always be less than its life. Now, next, let us try to find a duration of a 7-year 0% bond, that is a zero coupon bond, which is trading at a yield of 10%. We again construct the table. So since it's a 7-year bond, in the year column you would have 7 years. Now, cash flows, if you notice, there are no cash flows for 6 years, and in the last year, only the principal amount would be repaid. This is because you will all know by now that zero coupon bond are issued at a discount and redeemed at par, and no coupons are paid during the life of the bond. So you have cash flows which are nil for 6 years, and in the 7th year you're going to get your principal repayment. These will be discounted at 10% because the bonds are trading at a yield of 10%. So you get the discounted cash flow, and the sum total of discounted cash flow we know is the price of the bond, which in this case is 51.32. Then we find the proportion, and if you notice, in this case the proportion is zero in all the cases except for year 7, where the proportion becomes 1, because the year 7's discounted cash flow is 51.32 and the total discounted cash flow is also 51.32. So you have a proportion of 1. Next, we multiply the proportion with the year column, and since all the proportion for up to year 6 is 0, so the time weightage will also be 0, and for year 7 the proportion is 1 multiplied by the year 7 gives us time weightage of 7, and the sum total of time weightage we know is the duration. So in this case the duration is 7 years. Now the important thing to note here is duration of a zero coupon bond will always be equal to its life. This was a bond of 7 years and it was a zero coupon bond, and you notice the duration, it is 7 years. By now you should be in a position to understand the logic behind this. The reason is quite simple. In a coupon bearing bond, the investor receives coupons which are going to be invested and earn additional income. And because of this additional income, the investor is going to achieve his targeted cash flow much earlier than the life of the bond. But in case of a zero coupon bond, there are going to be no cash flows which can be invested. Hence, the investor will have to hold the bonds for 7 years to attain his targeted cash flows. In conclusion, we can say that we have learned 3 things here. 1. Duration represents the time that the investor needs to hold the bond to achieve his targeted cash flows. 2. The duration of a coupon bearing bond will always be less than its life. And 3. The duration of a zero coupon bond will always be equal to its life. Students, I hope you found this useful and easy to understand the concept of duration. In my forthcoming video clips, I would try to explain the concept of modified duration. Keep waiting for it and see you in a very short while. Thank you.